Greetings, YouTubers and Battlefield gamers. Alright, I'm bringing you this gameplay here of mostly, it's all jet combat. And this is the A-10 Thunderbolt, the U.S. close air-to-ground support fighter. And I want to let you know, like, some basic tips for flying the jets. Okay, so basically three steps. Number one, acquire your target, identify it, so know where it is, find it, okay? Number two, you gotta get in behind it and follow, track it, and keep on. Third, and obviously the most important one, you aim it and shoot it down with guns. Your guns are going to be the best way. Now, pretty much all the opposing pilots have flares, and if you're trying to knock them out with heat-seeking missiles, most of the time what will happen is you launch that missile and they will, you pop the flares and the missile will not lock on, so you're not going to get the kill. Now, if you want to still equip with heat seekers, that's fine, but what you can do then is when you get the lock, don't fire the heat seeker. They might pop their flares early, which is a mistake, and then once they pop their flares, wait a second, pop off that heat seeker, and typically then they will not be able to, their flares will not re-equip in time, and then what you can do is you can then shoot them down with the heat seeker will get them, or if it doesn't and maybe it just damages them, then you can finish them off with your guns, and that works well too. Okay, so you're watching me fly here on Caspian border. It's a great map for jet combat. It's just beautiful and not too complicated. It's pretty open space, which I like. And the reason I wanted to fly the Thunderbolt was I hadn't been flying it well because I've mostly been playing on Conquest maps. Or on this map, but on Conquest. Now, if you play on Conquest, at least all that I've seen, is you don't get the Thunderbolt, you get the Super Hornet, or I'm blanking out on the Russian one, maybe the Fulcrum, or I know the ground Russian fighter is the Frogfoot, but whatever the counterpart is to the Super Hornet, FA-18. So if you're playing Conquest, you get those, which are more air-to-air jets. They don't do as well on ground targets. These, the one I'm flying, which is the Thunderbolt, and then the Frogfoot, they are definitely more designed for knocking out tanks on ground targets. Obviously, you can still dogfight, as you can see, and have a lot of fun doing air-to-air combat. But if you want to take out ground targets, you're going to be able to use these more effectively. It has a, I want to say, 30mm cannon. If it's a Gatling gun or I think it's a Gatling gun, but you military experts, let me know. Tell me in the comments. I could look the specs up myself, but weigh in on what you think about the Thunderbolt. And also, I guess the Frogfoot is pretty much the same thing. I think they would probably have the same specs. I don't know. I don't think they'd make one better than the other, just because they want a balanced game. They want each plane to basically have the same characteristics and be able to match up equally. But I don't know. Some people have a preference where they're like, no, I like the American one. No, I like the Russian one. Same thing with the other jets. No, I like the Super Hornet. No, I like the Russian jet. So let me know. Let me know which is your favorite and why. And maybe we can kind of figure out the different pluses and minuses, pros and cons for each jet. Because I'm certainly interested in getting better flying and knowing what each one is best at or how to use each one most effectively is definitely a good thing. Okay. All right, so you see me flying around here. Now, one of the other kind of basic tips that I'm sure everyone has already covered, but I'll say it again, is that when when you're flying, just, you know, you're not behind another jet. It's a lot easier, obviously, to fly in third person. You can see the entire map. You have such a wider field of vision, point of view, and you can really get a good sense of the entire, you know, the entire map and everything that's around you. So that's a tip right there. You switch to third person when you're out looking for targets and just trying to acquire a target, or just see, you know, see more what's around you. Okay. Then when you slide in behind a jet, you have to go in, like you can see, trying to attack a few ground targets here. You can then switch, or you have to really switch to, you don't have to, but to be effective, you probably do. You switch to your cockpit view, and then you can see your target, crosshairs, your reticle, and your airspeed if you need to look at that, except all your instrumentation and your heads-up, your HUD, and your heads-up display. Okay, and just to let you know, another good thing you can do is when you're flying and you're in between dogfights or you're scoping around for targets, fly at the edges of the map around the perimeter. Like if the map's a square or a rectangle, you're flying on the lines on the outside of the rectangle, looking into the rectangle. Okay? And a good way to do that is when you're flying along the edge of the map is use your free look. So you're in cockpit view, but then toggle your free look and then look to the side that's looking into the map, and you can then see you that way. And then, because it's a little more zoomed in than this third person. This is more wide angle, and it's a little bit more difficult to see. When you're in free look, you can kind of look, and it's more zoomed in, and you can basically spot things a little bit easier. So that's a tip. I would be doing that too in this video, but my free look button is not working. I've zeroed out all my joystick commands. This is on the PC version, obviously. But I got rid of all the joystick mapping and the on-foot tab and the vehicles tab, because I use a keyboard and mouse when I'm using tanks and stuff like that. So the only thing I use the joysticks for is the helicopter and the jet. And it was working fine. I had the free look working, no problem. I pressed a button to enable it, and then I used my, I have one of those, the hat switch on the top of the joystick where your thumb goes at the top, and then I would use that to look all around the cockpit on the outside. So it was working fine, but then all of a sudden it just stopped working. I deleted the mapping. I remapped it. I tried a different button to map it to. Nothing has worked so far. So I don't know if it's a glitch with the programming of the game. Maybe it's my joystick, but it was working. Now it's not. So I'm trying to figure it out, but it's very frustrating. So let me know, any PC players out there that have had issues with their joysticks. Tell me if you found any fixes, or if, what you've done to get it working again, or just any of your thoughts on the key mappings. Now, what I've heard is that there's actually no native joystick support in this game for the PC, which is just, so disappointing in my opinion. I think DICE and EA need to fix that quick. They need to issue a patch to make sure that the joystick support is there. And it's just, it's just real, a real big letdown. Now, I'm using a joystick. It's an old, they still sell it, but mine's old. It's probably, I've had it for, 10 years or something crazy like that. But it's a Logitech. It's the Extreme 3D Pro, which is pretty much just one of the mass market standard, straightforward joysticks. It's got the twist. It's got 6 buttons on the base. It's got the trigger, fire button, obviously, your index finger for the main gun. There's a button where your thumb kind of sits in a depression. So it contours to your hand nicely. You got the thumb button, which you can use for secondary missiles, whatever you want. And then there's 4 buttons on the very top, and those are situated around the POV, the hat switch, which is the little, down on the it's like a circle thing that you can click, you know, up, down, left, right, which I use for, you know, the free look. Once I click, I have a button on the base that I use to enable that, and then I use the hat switch to look around. It's really cool, and it works. It's fun. But if it's not working, then, it's just, it just makes things not as fun, a little bit more difficult, etc. Alright, so you can see I'm going through those three steps I listed in the very beginning of the video, just trying to, you know, acquire targets, and I'm really just practicing too, like, swooping around, getting the angle right as I'm trying to attack ground targets. Sometimes I'm coming in too hot. On my joystick, I don't know, tell me if you're using a joystick and you have a throttle, you know, it's a little, just a, but I don't know, it's a little switch that you actually slide. Mine is like, it's hard to describe. It's just, it rotates, it kind of swings up and down, and that's the actual throttle itself. But mine, the position of the throttle, it doesn't correspond to the actual, how fast you're going. Like, on mine, if I lower my throttle down a little bit to 3/4 speed, my jet is still going full speed. If I lower it all the way past halfway, then all of a sudden it'll start dropping down slower. So I don't know if it's just my joystick or what, but it doesn't really work like I want it to. So I'm really just struggling to slow my jet down the right way, and it's difficult for me because of the throttle. So I guess sliding it all the way down a break, like to go almost all the way down to zero speed, but I don't know. It's hard for me to figure it out. So, tell me if you guys have any tips or suggestions for that. All right. So, if you have any tips or insight into the throttle issue, post some comments, leave me some feedback, and see if I can figure that out. Maybe I can tweak something to make it a little bit better. But other than that, I've had a blast just practicing and trying to learn and do better. Just become a more effective pilot. I think one of the main issues is trying to help your team and actually, sort of a purpose there. Obviously, one of the benefits is, if you're a good pilot and you can knock out the other jets on the other team, and basically you set up and create air superiority over the battlefield, then that's really helping your team. The other jets aren't going to be harassing your ground vehicles and tanks, and they are going to then. Your ground forces are going to be able to basically operate without fear of getting knocked out by helicopters and jets. So, and that's one good thing. Another good thing is, once you do that, once you knock out the other jets or just keep them occupied, then you can always go after ground targets yourself, and then you really become effective. Because if you can, even if you don't like totally destroy a vehicle, if you can say go down and strafe a tank and knock the helicopter down, then your tanks, the tanks on your team, are going to be able to then blow it up or kill it with like one round or a couple rounds. So you really help your team that way too. And another benefit too is if you're spotting in the planes, if you use your spot key and it pops up enemies, then you're helping your team there, because you're going to spot vehicles and infantry that your teammates may or may not even know are there. So so that's a good help there too. Alright, so and let me know too as you're watching this video. Again, like I said, I'm not a pro pilot, so if you can and you can certainly give me a hard time if you want to, but I'm just trying my best. Honestly, I'm just trying to stay behind the other jet, and when I switch to this cockpit view, it's tough, man. I don't know if it's me, it's my aiming. Maybe it's the sensitivity of the joystick, and I don't know if it's easier with a keyboard and mouse to actually, hit the target. But man, when I'm in the jet, when I'm using that joystick, this little, the little crosshairs, it's like I'm struggling to keep it, either right on. I try and actually lead. That's another thing, is you want to lead the other aircraft because it's obviously moving. So you want to fire your bullet stream or shell stream. Excuse me, you're going to fire that in front of the other jet, and it'll fly right into your bullets. So that's something I'm obviously trying to work on as well. Sometimes I'm firing too far behind the jet, but the main thing is, it's tough to even get your little crosshair on there because, it's flying, it's kind of jiggling, not wildly, but it's jiggling over, and you get into the, the turbulence and that, so it's tough, man. I gotta practice more and just be able to do it a little bit better and make it easier on myself, because I find a lot of times I'll get in behind these jets and maybe I start firing from too far away or something, but I'm behind them and I just can't knock them out all the time. So that's something I'm working on. I'm trying to get better. Any suggestions, I welcome that, because I'll definitely try stuff to improve. Alright, so hey, thanks for watching. This video is winding down, and definitely leave me some comments. I'm going to put up another jet gameplay on Karg Island that was a real blast, that I had fun, and I will see you next time. Alright, thanks for watching.